Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do another lesson in French, which is to introduce oneself, which is called se présenter. As you can see here, se présenter, to present oneself. So whenever we present ourselves to somebody who is unknown to us, how do we start? So the first line or the first sentence that we say is our name, okay? So, how do we say my name is? Okay, as you all know, my name is Nidhi. So, I will say je m'appelle Nidhi. Je m'appelle Nidhi. So, this is my name is Nidhi. Je m'appelle Nidhi. Okay. Next. Coming next, I can tell where I reside. Okay. So, if I live in Delhi, I will say I live in Delhi, okay. J'habite à Delhi. J'habite à Delhi. I live in Delhi, okay. Then the third sentence that I can say is, if somebody asks me, from where do you come? For example, you belong to which city? Okay, so that is called I come from. Okay, we say I come from. So my native state is Haryana. So I would say je viens de Haryana. So like my grandfather, he belongs to Haryana. He came to Delhi and then, but yes, I would say I come from Haryana. Je viens de Haryana. Okay. Then, what could be the next sentence that you can talk about yourself? Okay. It could be your nationality. If maybe you're meeting somebody who doesn't belong to your country, okay? Maybe you have gone somewhere to some other foreign land. So yeah, at times people ask you, you come from which country? You belong to which country? So you can say, I am Indian, okay? So we will say, je suis, I am. Je suis, okay. So as I have already told you in my past videos that French is a gender-based language. That means what? The nouns are either masculine or feminine. They are divided. Okay. Unlike English, English is a neutral language. So in French, we have genders. So if it's a boy who is saying that I am Indian, he would say je suis Indien. And if it's a girl who is saying that I am Indian, she would say je suis Indien. Je suis Indien. Okay. Can you repeat, please? Je suis Indien. Je suis Indien. So here we are using nasal sounds. Okay. Then next sentence that you can say about yourself could be your profession. Okay. What do you do? So you can say that I am. So as you are a student, you are studying. You can say I am a student. Je suis a student. Étudiant. Je suis étudiant. If you're a boy, and if it's a female, a girl or a woman, she would say je suis étudiante. There will be e. An extra e would be added here to étudiant. Étudiant will become étudiante. Okay. Then, what could be the next sentence that you can say about yourself if you are introducing yourself to somebody? It could probably be your age. Okay, though I know that a lot of females do not prefer telling their age. But yeah, at least you should know how to say your age. Okay, if I am perhaps 15 years old, I would say J'ai 15 ans. Okay, 15. Numbers we have already done in our last videos. So how will 15 be written in French? You can write Q U I N Z E. 15. Okay. So generally we do not prefer in numbers. We prefer writing in words. Okay. J'ai 15 ans. Maybe if you are 20 years old, you can say J'ai 20 ans. If you are 18 years old, how would you say if you are 18 years old? J'ai 18 ans. Okay, if you are 30 years old, maybe, so you would say J'ai 30 ans. Okay, so this is how you tell your age. Then another sentence could be your civil status, that is your marital status. So you can say, I am married, je suis marié. If you are a male, je suis marié with extra E if you are a female. Okay, if you're a female, you're going to add an E in the end of marié. So it will become feminine. Okay, so this is masculine, this is feminine. I am married, je suis marié. Okay, if you are single, if you're not married, in French we call it célibataire. Célibataire. And it's already ending in E. So for both masculine or feminine, we will use the same form. Je suis célibataire. Je suis célibataire. Please repeat once so that you understand how you have to pronounce it. Je suis célibataire. Okay. The next sentence probably could be which languages you generally speak. Okay. If you are visiting some foreign land, or maybe you have met some foreigners, if you are in an interview, there could be various places where you need to tell which all languages you know to speak. So you can say je parle. Je parle means I speak. Je parle. So as I know multiple languages, I'm going to tell how to say that I speak. So I speak French, I speak English, I speak Hindi, I speak Punjabi, I speak Haryanvi. These are few languages that I know to speak. So I can enlist all of them or maybe a few of them. Okay. Je parle Hindi. How do we say English in French? Anglais. 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 Je parle Hindi. Anglais. Okay. If you know to speak French, then Francais. There will be a cédille in the C. Okay. Je parle Hindi. Anglais. And if that is the third language that you know, you should write ET. ET means and. And. ET has to be added here. Okay, if you know more than these languages, you can add them as well. Okay, je parle Hindi, anglais et français. Okay, I would request you to please once again repeat all the 8 sentences with after me so that you can pronounce them better when you have to use them. Okay, let's start. Je m'appelle Nidhi. You can take your name here please instead of Nidhi. Je m'appelle Nidhi. Je m'appelle Nidhi. J'habite à Delhi. Obviously now wherever you live, the city where you live, you can write that, or maybe name of your country also. Okay, if I want to say I live in India, I would say j'habite, then instead of a, I have to write en. J'habite en and. India in French is called and. I-N-D-E. And. Okay. J'habite en Inde. J'habite en Inde. Okay. The next sentence. Je viens de Haryana. So now you can say the name of your town, name of your city, name of your country, depending upon the situation you are answering or you are speaking this line. Okay. Je viens de Haryana. Je suis Indien. Je suis Indien. Je suis Indien. Je suis Indien. For male, je suis Indien. For female, je suis Indien. Okay, the next sentence. I am student. Je suis étudiant. Je suis étudiant if you are a male. Je suis étudiante if you are a female. Je suis étudiante. Okay, the next for age. J'ai 15 ans. J'ai 20 ans. J'ai 30 ans. Whatever is your age, just write your age here and repeat the sentence. J'ai 15 ans. J'ai 15 ans. Ans means years. Okay. Je suis marié. If you're a male. For male and female, both pronunciation is same. Okay. Here the pronunciation remains the same. But the spellings are different. Okay. Je suis marié. Je suis marié. And if you are single, je suis célibataire. Je suis célibataire. Okay, I hope you are repeating after me. Je parle Hindi. Okay, if you speak only one language, you would say je parle Hindi. If it's only Hindi. Okay, and if you speak English, only English, je parle anglais. If you speak only French, then it's je parle français. Okay, and if you speak all these languages, then you can say je parle hindi, anglais et français. Et français. So I hope this lecture was very clear to you how you are going to introduce yourself to somebody meeting for the first time, or maybe anybody who is asking you about you, and you should be able to tell your age, the place where you live, your name, you come from which city, which state, which country. I hope you have understood. Please write in comment section if you have any doubts, if you want to know any other sentence. Please keep watching our more videos. Do subscribe to our channel, and if you like this video, please hit the like button. Thank you so much. Take care. We'll meet again with another video.